Item number, SCP-287. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-287 is stored in a climate-controlled secure locker in Site-22 in order to prevent additional deterioration. At this time, no additional testing is required, but may be approved by Dr. Sigurd Olofsson. Sources of electricity are to be kept away from SCP-287's locker at all times. If testing with SCP-287 is required, insulated gloves are to be worn to prevent accidental discharge into the hilt. SCP-287-1's remains are to be kept in storage until further notice. Research requests for SCP-287-1 can be routed to Dr. Zarshin and are restricted to Level 4 personnel or Level 2 personnel from the Exobiology Department. Description: SCP-287 is a Viking arming sword, measuring 78 centimeters from pommel to tip and weighing 1,077 grams. SCP-287 is in a state of significant decay due to exposure to outside elements for anywhere from 900 to 1100 years. SCP-287 was found in Iceland, alongside several written records. SCP-287 is comprised primarily of iron, with several potentially anomalous components incorporated into its structure. Several of these materials have been detected by Foundation probes traveling within extrasolar regions of our galaxy, as well as probes which... Carbon dating has placed SCP-287's creation to around the early 10th century CE. Samples of exoplanetary metals and materials have proven to be more difficult to date, and analysis is ongoing. SCP-287's anomalous effect can be observed when an electrical current is applied through the metallic portions of the hilt, exposed just below the guard. These exposed elements are in a noticeably better state than the iron portions of SCP-287. SCP-287's internal components will begin to emit several frequencies of EM radiation and varying sounds, invariably described as distressing by research staff and test subjects. Radiation produced by SCP-287 causes all humans who are exposed to it to experience acute audiovisual hallucinations and severe headaches. SCP-287's specific hallucination takes the form of translucent human-like figures in the immediate vicinity, invariably outfitted as members of an armed force. The armament and armor worn by SCP-287's hallucinations varies by subject, but with a general trend towards the individual's perception of what they consider to be modern armament. Testing with animals as well as non-anomalous EM fields and sounds of the exact same frequencies do not produce the same effect in any combination of cases. Higher amperage currents have increased this effect to a maximum of 437 individual hallucinations. Further testing was deemed unnecessary. SCP-287-1 is believed to be an extraterrestrial organism found in the same location as SCP-287. The exact origin of SCP-287-1 is unknown at this time. A full report on SCP-287-1 can be found in document R27-287-1. SCP-287-1's potential spacecraft, designated SCP-287-2, appears to be completely destroyed. The current working hypothesis for SCP-287-2 is that it was intended as some form of escape pod from a larger vessel. Discovery: SCP-287 was recovered from a burial mound outside of Iceland on January 2000. The remains found within the tomb proved to be non-human, and the Foundation took custody of SCP-287, and the remains were designated SCP-287-1. SCP-287-1's remains are skeletal and are humanoid, though significantly different from human skeletal structure. Additionally, several written sources were found within the tomb and acquired by the Foundation. Dr. Sigurd Olofsson was consulted to help translate the writing enclosed in Addendum A. Addendum A, prepared by the Department of Terra Linguistics. The discovery of SCP-287 was predicated upon reports of ghost soldiers in an area outside of Iceland. A recent storm had struck the burial mound containing SCP-287, conducting current into SCP-287 through a crude lightning rod made of iron. The hallucinations created by SCP-287 affected an amateur film crew. The crew informed local authorities, and Foundation information gathering subroutines flagged these reports as potentially anomalous. Keywords: ghost, specter, crazy, kids, hallucination, with a double correlation factor of gamma 6. Class A amnestics were administered to all witnessing parties, and the burial site was declared a heritage dig site through a Foundation shell corporation. Within the burial mound, Foundation agents discovered SCP-287, SCP-287-1, and additional written materials dating back to the early 10th century CE. A transcription was created by Dr. Sigurd Olofsson. Unintelligible sections are most likely proper nouns, with no direct translation. I am Halvor Skottesson, Scald of Unintelligible, and I have been trusted with the tale of Thor's champion, the Meteor Lord. In the depths of winter, the year after the Great Raid, we saw a fiery meteor in the sky. It landed deep in the heart of the Northern Wastes, and we followed it. A wondrous thing it was, gleaming and covered in ghost lights. We approached and found a man standing in a heavy cloak, examining the meteor. The ghost lights went dark, and the figure pressed his hand to the outside of the star. A wondrous light filled our eyes as the star opened. He disappeared into the meteor and emerged to look at us with such fiery determination in his eyes. We knew he could only be a king, sent to us from Odin himself. He would protect us from the raids, and we would know prosperity again. Our prayers had been answered. Daily did the elders of our village come to his resting site, but his tongue was blessed only to speak the language of the Aesir. Weeks passed as he learned our language. When he learned of our plight, he appeared to grow angry and charged back to the meteor to fashion himself a mighty weapon with which to defend the village. Weeks later, he emerged with a sword in his hand, gleaming and mighty. He held it aloft, and his power was made manifest. Ghostly warriors, heroes from Valhalla, stood around him, brandishing weapons. We threw ourselves to the ground, our heads aching with the glory of these Valhalla warriors, and this pleased the Meteor Lord. For years, when the raids came, we ran in supplication to the Meteor Lord. He emerged, and all fled from his flashing blade and burning eyes. We marked the way to the Meteor Lord's home with the cairn stones. During the Battle of Unintelligible, the Meteor Lord's fall came. His powers failed him, and Odin recalled him to Valhalla. We buried him with all the honor we could muster, and fashioned a conduit for the great storms from Thor. On stormy nights, the heroes still come and watch over our village, their glory splitting the head of any man who dare look upon them. Addendum B. Prepared by the Department of Exolinguistics. Tracing back from the story presented in the included writings, Foundation agents tracked down the meteor mentioned in the epic translated by Dr. Olofsson. Excavating the object in question led to an almond-shaped craft made of an unknown material. Research regarding this craft can be found in document R27-287. Within the craft, several records were found, written in an unknown language upon crude paper. It is hypothesized that this is some kind of journal of SCP-287-1. An exact translation is nearly impossible. However, using a partial translation has been attempted. Timestamp: unknown symbology, unknown place, unknown people, primitive, violent. Untranslated didn't survive. Everything is lost. Must find a way back. Too many counting on me. Timestamp: unknown symbology theorized to be several days later. They found me. Managed to put together untranslated hood. They won't see me. Must learn their language. Must keep them away from me. Unknown biology may infect. Timestamp: unknown symbology theorized to be several weeks later. I see their weapons. Mine non-functional. made one like theirs, used last of the untranslated, tuned to alien brain chemistry. Hope it scares them off. Not sure how much longer I can work on untranslated. Not having, most likely a proper noun, nearby is unbearable, dying, breaking. Timestamp. Unknown symbology. Unknown time. They came back. I use the weapon. Scares them. Untranslated. Almost done. May be able to leave. Down to 16 cells? Items? Spheres? Timestamp. Unknown symbology. Unknown time. They brought others. I scared them again. Not sure if I can repair the untranslated. Thought I had enough. Closest match was a chemical formula matching SCP-148. Used most likely a proper nouns. Necklace. Still not enough. Timestamp. Unknown symbology theorized to be several years later. Won't stop coming. Only one cells. Items. Spheres. Left. Time running out. Power nearly gone. I can't repair. Untranslated. Too many. Unit of time. It is hypothesized that at this point, whatever power source SCP-2871 was using to activate SCP-287 ran out. SCP-2871 was most likely killed during the next raid, without SCP-287 to protect them. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-286, The Brothers Game, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.